I keep getting DNS server not responding errors. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's another variation of that same question. My ISP's DNS servers are timing out frequently. DNS server not responding. What can I do? The DNS system, domain name system, is what turns an internet name like www.google.com into an internet IP address such as 142.250.217.110. That's how the computers actually communicate, is using those numbers rather than those names, but the DNS system has to convert those names into numbers before the computers can actually do that. Now, by default, your ISP will provide your computer with the DNS servers it's supposed to use. Unfortunately, ISPs have kind of a mixed track record on which DNS servers they provide. It's kind of a running joke that sometimes the DNS provided by some ISPs is some ancient computer sitting in a corner that's there only because they have to provide something. Well, that ancient computer is usually pretty slow, and that can actually manifest as apparent slowness in your internet activity. So let's find out if you're having a DNS problem. So what I'm going to do first is run Windows command prompt. And what I'm going to do is type a command called ping, and then I'll just say google.com. Now, when I do that, a couple of different things are going to happen. You'll notice that it actually responded very, very quickly. That's good. The very first thing that the ping command had to do was to actually convert google.com into the actual IP address of a Google service. Had there been a delay, that would have told us that perhaps our DNS service wasn't up to snuff. What happens next is that the ping command just sort of makes sure that it can connect to that service and get a reply from it, which in this example it has. But you'll notice that, again, that initial response from hitting return to getting that pinging google.com with an IP address was very, very fast. That's really good. Now, if you have a DNS problem, if there's a delay there of some sort, then you end up looking at switching your DNS servers to something else. There's nothing that says you have to use your ISP's provided DNS servers. What DNS servers am I running? Well, here's another command for you, ipconfig /all. Now, in my case, I've got a few other things going on here, but the most important thing is DHCP server. In my case, the 10.1.10.1 means that this computer is using my router as its DNS server. That's actually fairly common. The next step would be to go to the router and see which DNS server it is configured to use to get answers to questions for which it doesn't already have an answer. That's where we would be making changes to the DNS server. Now, you can make changes to the DNS on your computer only if you want to. In my case, rather than having it use 10.1.10.1, I can configure it to use some other service. My article, How Do I Change the DNS Used by My Computer, discusses both how to change the DNS for your specific Windows computer or how to change the DNS provided by your router. What do you change it to? Well, there are, as it turns out, several different public DNS services that are often more private. They're often more secure because they actually block known bad websites. And bonus, they're often significantly faster than that old PC in a corner your ISP might be using. Some of the examples include Cloudflare's 1.1.1.1, perhaps the easiest DNS server to remember. Google has its own public DNS you could use. Open DNS is another one that's been around for a very long time. It's now owned by Cisco. Again, there are many third-party DNS servers that you can consider trying to see if they resolve any perceived performance issues. My recommendation is that you try it on one of your PCs first, if you have more than one, just to see if it makes a difference. And then, if it does, consider updating your router so that all of the PCs on your local network, all of the phones, all of the other devices on your local network end up using the same, faster, safer third-party DNS. Hope that helps. For updates, for comments, and especially for related links to some of these third-party services, visit askleo.com/1842. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.